Hi, and welcome to Mastering Maven for Java Projects, from beginners to CI/CD expert. I'm Kaushik, and in this course, we'll take a hands-on journey through one of the most powerful tools in the Java development world, that is Apache Maven. Whether you are a developer, a test automation engineer, or just someone who is new to Java build tools, this course will give you the skills to set up, build, manage, and deploy Java projects like a pro. Here's what you'll learn in this course: how Maven works and why it is widely adopted in enterprises environment, how to manage dependencies, configure plugins, and structure your project, how to integrate Maven into CI/CD pipeline using Jenkins, and finally, how to troubleshoot, build executable jars, and prepare real-world developments. Ready to get started? Let's begin with the basics: what is Maven and how it works. In this video, I'm going to give an introduction to Maven, and then we'll learn what is Maven and the core concepts. What is Maven and why to use it? Apache Maven is a build automation and project management tool used primarily for Java projects. It was designed to simplify the build process by introducing convention over configuration, meaning it follows standard project structures and build lifecycle, so you don't have to write custom build scripts every time. But Maven is much more than just a build tool. It manages projects dependencies from a central repository. It standardizes project build with a unified POM.XML. It supports multiple model project plugins and automated documentation generation. Think of it like this: if a Java project were recipes, Maven would be the chef that knows exactly what ingredients to fetch, how to mix them, and when to serve them. Let us understand the difference between Maven and other build tools in a simple theoretical way. Maven was introduced in the year 2004, whereas Ant was introduced in the year of 2000, and it is considered to be outdated, where only few of the legacy projects use Ant. Maven uses the XML as a build language, and it has a declarative configuration style. Maven has its own dependency managers, which is built in, and it is transitive. What is transitive? I will come to that in a moment. The learning curve is moderate, and it has, of course, the built-in lifecycle as well. Gradle was introduced in the year 2012, and it is somewhat advanced than Maven, I can say, but it is mostly used in the Java project, particularly for the Android development where Kotlin is used. Let's break down the inner working of Maven. It all starts with a file called POM.XML, which stands for Project Object Model. Don't get confused with your Selenium POM, that is page object model. It is different. This file is the heart of your Maven project. It defines the project details like group ID, artifact ID, versions. What are those? We'll learn in the upcoming videos. All your external libraries called dependencies, and all the dependencies are get downloaded from the Maven central repository, or maybe there can be a custom repository as well. It also contains build settings, plugins, and goals. There are multiple life cycles. We'll learn throughout in our course, but mostly used as compile, test, package, and install. Maven fetches all the required libraries from the Maven central repository or other custom repos, as I mentioned, and stores them in your local repository. Usually .m2 is the folder. So you define what you need in your POM.XML, and Maven take care of the rest of the things. Let's understand the dependency resolution and transitive dependencies. Maven automatically resolves and includes the dependencies of your dependencies. Confusing? Let me clear with an example. Let's say you are adding a library A, which internally calls the library of B and C. Maven adds B and C for you. That this is transitive resolution. You don't have to worry about the inner dependencies which are dependent on your dependency. For a real-time example, let's take Selenium. Let's say it's Selenium version 4. Which internally depends on the Chromium or the Firefox dependencies, right? So when we add the Selenium, internally it calls the Chrome or the Firefox dependencies. And also it will conflict the resolution. For example, if two dependencies bring different versions of the same library, Maven uses the nearest definition in the dependency tree. We can see the dependency tree with the command Maven dependency colon tree. We'll see that maybe in the future video. In the next video, we'll learn how to set up your Maven in your project. Before that, let me quickly give you a summarize whatever we have learned so far. What is Maven? Maven is a build tool specifically for Java project. And how it works? It works based on the lifecycle, the phases, and the build commands. I've also learned the theoretical way of dependency and what is transitive dependencies. We'll look further in our upcoming videos. Until I see you in the next video, go and check it out, Learn by Test platform, where we have plenty of blogs to read. And of course, you can learn all the new trending automation tools. See you in the next one very soon. Tada, bye bye. Take care.